Hello there, beautiful people, and welcome back to my gaming series. And today, I'm just going to show you some more PSVR and WIZDISH ROVR gameplay. And today, this one is No Man's Sky Beyond the fucking game. I mean, it's just awesome, isn't it? Let's be honest. I mean, I was waiting ages for this, just like many of you other people out there were. And I jumped in the moment it was launched, the moment it finally got fucking realised. And I was having a fucking blast. It was amazing. I mean, I couldn't even believe how amazing it was, to be quite honest with you. It really took me out of the fucking the real world and stuck me right in that space game, and I fucking love that. You know, and I knew from the moment that No Man's Sky was going to be out, as soon as I had the idea of the world working on it, I pretty much knew it would work straight away, just by the way the control schemes were said when they did their press release. So as soon as that was the case, I decided to add a haptic feedback. Like I said in the other video, I got the old Aura Interactor working with the PSVR. As you can see, it's just hanging onto the side of the rover. Now, you don't have to have it like that. I just found it was like that due to this extra external power bit that comes with it. As you can see, it's just on the floor next to my TV and rover. Now, I'm trying to either come up with a better way of showing this, maybe downplaying some of my other aspects. I quite like this design, where the TV is in front of the rover. I mean, that's pretty cool. If you like that, please let me know. And yeah, you know, I'm really having a blast of it. I've got so many other games to test, obviously. It's just, it's an ordeal, I tell you. Putting yourself in some VR will kind of mess you up a little bit. But yeah, No Man's Sky, fantastic fucking game. I mean, obviously, we were all there when it launched originally, and I was one of the people who said it was shit. I'm not going to lie to you, but the Beyond version was fantastic. And as you can see here, I am playing it on the PSVR with a VR treadmill. And if you've been following me, if you've subscribed to my channel, you know how I did this. You know, there's a how-to video on there, but what there isn't a how-to video for is to use the Bluetooth dongle that comes free with the Cosmax Plus. Now, the reason why is because it took me a while to actually get the Bluetooth adapter to work. And I don't know why it took me a while. I think I just didn't fully understand it. But when I got it working, that allowed games for a plethora of different like scenarios, such as Resident Evil became accessible, and there's other games that I don't really want to say, but I don't really matter, does it? Like Here They Lie and stuff like that. Here They Lie will be a video I'll be putting out there pretty soon. So there's a little sneak peek there. As well as many other horror games. I'm really into horror VR, if you can tell. You know, I wouldn't mind giving the exorcism games a go, that'd be pretty sweet. Paranormal Activity, definitely, I need to play that, it was fantastic. I played it on HTC Vive. Can't wait to play that on the PSVR with some WIZDISH ROVR action in there. Honestly, you need to buy WIZDISH ROVR. If you've been watching my channel for a little bit of time now, you will know that I've been using the WIZDISH ROVR with the PSVR almost exclusively. I don't even go on the PSVR, or the PS4 for that matter, unless I'm using the ROVR. It's all, in my eyes, it's all the same thing now. I can't use it without the other. I can't pick up my PSVR headset and not use the ROVR, and I definitely can't not put my haptic vest on now I've tried it. I mean, that is some straight up fucking magical kind of shit right there. I mean, when you run in a game using your own feet and punching in your own hands, and then enemy hits you and you feel that punch, it is kind of like an out of body experience. That shit is amazing. Like, there's no wonder that people set up arcades for VR and have all this shit, and they just charge a shit ton of money. I mean, I can understand it. Like, after designing it all myself and having this set up myself, I could definitely understand why people would fucking sell this idea. But I suppose me showing you how to do it on the cheap is kind of a sting in their plans, really, isn't it? But, you know, I'm here to show the gamers out there, you know, just my fellow gamers and people that want to get into gaming, how they too can have the best immersive VR experience, you know, without spending a ton of money. Now, you know, the rover isn't 100% cheap, but it's only £500, really, and that's just the price of a PS4 and PSVR headset anyway. So, you know, I honestly think it's a good deal. I mean, I had a lot of people on Reddit and that saying that I should get into PC VR. And, you know, I have tested it. I had the HTC Vive for a while. But, you know, I don't have it anymore. And I just don't have a really capable gaming PC at all, to be quite honest with you. I could do it. I could get one. But with this setup now, with the PSVR and everything, I do not see the point. Like, this is so far beyond what normal PC VR is doing, that I kind of prefer this at the moment, to be honest with you. It's just kind of a different level of gaming right now. Like, there is sitting there in front of your screen playing 2D games. I love my emulators. I still play, Your Mario Sunshine, Sonic Adventure and all that kind of stuff, never going to stop playing that. But a large majority of the time I'm in a different world, I'm playing VR, you know, I'm in No Man's Sky, I'm in Resident Evil, I've got my ass kicked by Mia a few times, I mean, that is weird. Especially when you use the haptic feedback first, I mean, getting smacked and then feeling that chainsaw go up your back, oh god, does that just messes you right up, that does. But fantastic experience, without a doubt. If you want to check this out, you know, there will be a video going up soon that will show you how to use the Bluetooth dongle, and that will let you use games that only support the DualShock 4, and then you can use that as well, and you know, it makes a lot more games accessible. But I have to admit that basically any game now with this setup and the Bluetooth dongle, you can play using the Rover. You know, there's no doubt about that. I could play games that aren't really supposed to be done with VR. I could do it. I could play Spider-Man PS4 if I wanted with the Rover, but there's no real point to it. I could do it, but it's no real point to it. But any VR game now that supports the DualShock 4, I don't even have to support the Wiimote, not the Wiimotes, the Move controllers, you can still use it. You know, our aim controller, yeah, not a problem. All of it is compatible with the WIZDISH ROVR thanks to the power of the Cronus Max Plus. And, you know, really cannot stress that enough. You need a Cronus Max Plus, I suppose. A Titan 1 might do it, but I have tested that, so I can only vouch for the Cronus Max Plus at the moment. But, yeah, you know, if you're getting into VR gaming, and if you already are into it and you want a massive gaming experience, it's just one that will blow everything else out of the water, the WIZDISH ROVR is the way to go. You know, I'm backing them 100% without a doubt. So yeah, you know, I'm afraid I've only got time for today, the people. So once again, I've been me and you've been you. And thank you so much for joining me on my gaming series. Please join me next time for something else. Bye bye for now.